Number 9, Zachary Davis.
I killed Melanie and left Josh alive to suffer. I didn't feel anything when I killed her, even when her blood splattered on my arm and her brain matter was thrown onto my shirt.
August 10th, 2012. 15-year-old Zachary Davis did a terrible thing. He callously killed his own mother and tried to set his house on fire with his brother still inside. Now, Zach wasn't always like this. When he was younger, he was a quiet kid. But things got really bad after his dad died from ALS when he was just 9 years old. Zach started hearing voices and was diagnosed with schizophrenia and depression. Sadly, his family stopped his therapy too soon, not realizing that it would lead to something really awful. That dreadful night, Zachary, his mother Melanie, and older brother Josh returned from the movie theater. While Melanie slept, Zachary retrieved a sledgehammer from the basement and bludgeoned her to death, striking her nearly 20 times. He then set their family game room on fire, intending to kill Josh as well. Fortunately, Josh escaped due to the fire alarm, discovering the gruesome scene. In a heart-wrenching interview with Dr. Phil McGraw, Zach displayed a shocking lack of remorse as his journal entry was read out loud. When he was asked why he killed his mother, he just said,
"She wasn't taking care of my family."
He described the murder weapon as making a wet thumping sound and explained that he wanted to make sure his mother was dead, so he struck her nearly 20 times. His words and lack of empathy really painted a chilling picture of a young man who had gone down this dark path. Now, Zach's trial was very disturbing. He tried to blame his brother Josh for the murder, but his lawyer admitted that Zach was guilty, saying,
"You turned into a bad person, Mr. Davis. You did terrible things."
In the end, the court made Zach take responsibility for what he did. He was sent to a secure psychiatric facility where he would get the help for his mental health problems. The legal system understood that mental illness played a big part in this horrible crime.
No, Your Honor.
Today is the sentencing of the defendant for the purposeful and intentional murders of Davion Flanagan and Dominic Russo. And in a way, it's the second time their families are gathered again to grieve. It's also a day when Mackenzie's family will grieve for the future of their daughter. All three of these families and the friends of these families are suffering, and all of their lives have been irrevocably changed because of the actions of the defendant. The unintended and collateral consequences of a selfish, intentional, and cruel decision by Mackenzie will ripple forever in time. It's literally changed history because it's ended two lives. Two young men are dead. Their deaths were horrible, terrifying, and tragic. I will say again, if any reasonable person reviews Exhibit 802, there can be no doubt in your mind what happened this night. There can be no doubt of the absolute terror of the two people in that car. The defendant controlled all the events. She chose the day. Specifically, she chose a day just before her 18th birthday. She chose to drive the car, the time to drive the car. She chose an obscure, previously scouted route through an industrial parkway. She chose the target to hit and the victims. She chose the means and the method to follow through. And she planned and purposefully executed the events of July 31st, 2022. The review of the evidence supports the factual findings, the forensic testimony, the testimony of the first responders, the testimony of the emergency room doctors who treated the defendant, the testimony of the coroner's medical examiner, the testimony of those who knew the victims and the defendant, and the testimony of the BMV official who provided evidence that not only did the defendant deny any medical condition when applying for her license, which her mother co-signed and attested to, but also that just after the accident, Mackenzie renewed her driver's license and again denied any medical condition. In fact, the defendant was so concerned about driving that, as the state mentioned, during the investigation, she asked if they could just suspend her license for 10 years. It is hard to fathom how a person could be concerned about their driving privileges, having just been responsible for the deaths of two people. There was no medical condition that caused this as an accident. There was no mechanical failure of the car. The record is clear on the facts and the evidence. Her mother's uncorroborated statements without any medical testimony or records is not persuasive. It is also important to remember that even if Mackenzie intended to also die in this crash, that is irrelevant. A failed suicide attempt is not a defense to murder. And even in a murder-suicide attempt, when a perpetrator executing the plan survives, the other death or deaths are still murder. There's only one person who's responsible for the pain of everyone in this room, and that person is you, Mackenzie. Nobody else is responsible. This isn't the fault of Dominic's family, or Davion's family, or your family. And I know that each of you have asked your questions to yourselves, what if? What if I had done this or that? The truth of it is, none of us can control the intentions of another. And when there is a purposeful intent to harm or kill someone, it is the perpetrator alone who bears the responsibility for the choice and the consequences and the harm that follows. The difficulty for sentencing today, honestly, is whether or not I believe you should get consecutive sentences. I'm troubled that should I give you a concurrent sentence, that people will believe that somehow I'm being disrespectful to one of the victims. And on the other hand, I have to weigh the punishment. There's a very good likelihood, Mackenzie, that you will spend the rest of your life in prison. That won't be up to me. That will be up to the parole board, and that will be up to you to a great extent. I understand that the pain in this room wants me to impose the harshest sentence, but I don't believe that would be the appropriate sentence, because I do believe that Mackenzie will not be out in 15 years. So she's sentenced on count two, the murder of Davion Flanagan, 15 years to life. She's sentenced on count one, the murder of Dominic Russo, 15 years to life, to be served concurrent to each other with credit for time served. I'll waive fines, fees, and costs, and your appellate counsel will be assigned. Are there any questions from the state?
No, Your Honor, thank you.
Any questions?
No, Your Honor.
All right, thank you.
You're innocent.
My point to this whole double video is, why can't Mackenzie Shirilla get the same thing the guy in the first video got? He purposely took a weapon and hit his mother with it over and over and over and over. Mackenzie did not do this. She was simply driving a car. Gas pedal got stuck, I believe. I have no proof for that. And what did they give her? 2 15 years back to back. Why don't they give her a put her in a therapy place and, you know, give her mental treatments? And the guy in the first video, boy, he in my opinion, he more or less walked. Slap on the wrist. This girl here, oh boy. So I vote set Mackenzie Shirilla free. Thank you very much for listening and watching.